What's going on, moviegoers? So if you're new to the channel, my name is Christian. Welcome to SeaWorld Productions. Ryan Coogler has signed an exclusive deal with Disney to continue on the story of Wakanda for Disney Plus. This is huge, you guys. This is massive. The fact that they got Ryan Coogler for 5 years and his production company to really expand on the world of Wakanda is massive and extremely important. What Ryan Coogler did with Black Panther revolutionized that comic book character. That film brought so many people together, so many cultures together. It was a cultural movement. It was huge. It was beautiful. I'm excited to see what kind of story he's whipped up for Black Panther 2. It's going to be a little difficult because with the passing of Chadwick Boseman, but I have 110% full faith in Ryan Coogler and Marvel Studios with what they plan on doing with the sequel to Black Panther. But the possibilities for Ryan Coogler to continue on to tell stories in Wakanda for Disney Plus is massive. I must have done 2 or 3 videos on this of saying how I want to see Disney Plus series on Wakanda and certain groups of Wakanda or certain characters of Wakanda. This is huge, you guys, and this is coming from Deadline. I'm going to read you guys a little bit of this article, and I'm going to talk about what I want to see from Ryan Coogler and Marvel Studios for their whole Wakanda series. Exclusive. The Walt Disney Company has extended its relationship with Black Panther director and co-writer Ryan Coogler. Disney has made a 5-year overall exclusive television deal with Coogler's Proximity Media. That is huge. 5 years. 5 years of extended content in the world of Wakanda being overseen by Ryan Coogler. I doubt he's going to direct everything. He's probably going to direct a couple of things, and he's probably going to be a producer. But I can't wait to see what kind of creative team he comes up with when we're talking about the world of Wakanda on a Disney Plus format. This is huge and massive, and I'm 110% supportive of this decision. Continuing on, the first one will delight Black Panther's fans. A drama based in the Kingdom of Wakanda for Disney Plus. The deal also enables Proximity to develop television for other divisions of the company. So interesting. He's going to be doing stuff for Marvel and other things outside of Marvel for Disney. Damn. A drama series. A drama series based in the Kingdom of Wakanda. Now, I've stated this before. 3 series I would love to see done. I want to see a Dora Milaje spinoff series. A lot of strong, important, smart Black women whipping ass for Disney Plus. Come on, viewership would be out the sky. Then I would want to see, obviously you have Okoye and everybody return. Then you would have, I would want to see a T'Chaka series. A T'Chaka prequel series, that is. Maybe even kind of have Captain America go up against T'Chaka, you know, way back in the day. Because I remember, I think it was the John Romita run? Where T'Chaka or T'Chaka's grandfather had went up against Captain America. Or you can introduce a younger Claw and have that whole, you know, prequel type story. I think that could really work and they can really capitalize off that story. Or M'Baku. I think the great ape M'Baku and his whole tribe, what's his tribal name? Oh my God. The Jabari tribe. I think that could be really interesting. There's a lot of backstory in his, especially since they really switched it up. Because M'Baku in the comic books, he always went at it with Black Panther. They were rivals. They didn't like each other. So, you know, they switched it up for the live action stuff. But I feel like they can dive deep into the history of the Jabari tribe as well. You know what I mean? They can do a lot of good stuff in the world of Wakanda. A lot of good, you know, hidden gems that we haven't yet to see or experience in the world of Wakanda. Because there's so many other tribes, the Border Tribe, you name it. There's just so much more. You know what I mean? I have a whole Black Panther guidebook, and there's just a lot of info just based on the world of Wakanda. And you know, Ryan Coogler's already been doing his homework. You know what I mean? Whatever he has planned for Black Panther 2, you know, with the whole, you know, Atlantis possibly coming up. You know what I mean? And this is I wanted to talk about as well. This is coming from Fandom Wire. Now, they have already reported that Ryan Coogler saying it's an exclusive. Ryan Coogler was going to be, not Ryan Coogler, sorry. Wow, totally fucked up his name. Eric Killmonger, Michael B. Jordan, will be returning to the sequel to Black Panther. And they also just came out today and said in exclusive, we've gotten some more details, stating that Killmonger will be getting his own Disney Plus series. I don't know how much of that is true or authentic, but I don't think it's really necessary for a Killmonger to get his own TV series. I really don't. I'd be down to have Killmonger return to the world of Black Panther and Wakanda and kind of have him pick up the mantle or something like that. But there's no need for a Killmonger series, especially if it's going to be like something of a prequel. I don't think, you know, it's needed. But who knows? Like I said, I'm taking that with a grain of salt. Don't really know if that's true or not. But it's going to be interesting to see what happens, man. I mean, I'm excited that Ryan Coogler is officially back. Going to be doing his thing for Marvel and Disney. You know, there's so much world to build around of when we're talking of the world of Wakanda. And it's going to be fun. It's going to be fun. I cannot wait. But post your comments down below. Let me know what you guys think about Ryan Coogler coming back to the world of Wakanda to do Disney Plus series. What are your thoughts? What are your opinions? And what would you like to see be made by Ryan Coogler and his production team? Peace. We out. We out. We out. We out.